6th International Conference on Health, Wellness and Society. Emotional Intelligence and its Application in the Practice of Medicine. Luis Jimenez, MID, Independent Researcher. Message for all researchers and scientists making presentations today. To create carries a huge responsibility and arise a question. Is this creation useful for and good for humanity? If your answer is positive, you know what you have to do despite all the difficulties. Communication between patients and health staff is the most effective. Do we know the emotions we face? Do we identify these emotions in ourselves? Can emotion help us care for patients? With the growing technological capabilities, are we losing the ability to communicate among ourselves and with our patients? Among students in the health sector, are the communication skills and understanding of emotion being studied? Emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence, or emotional quotient, is the ability of individuals to recognize their own and other people's emotions, to discriminate feelings and classify them appropriately, to use this information for better decision-making. There are clearly definite structures in our brain, frontal lobe, limbic system, amygdala, and thalamus, to name a few, which have an harmonic interaction. These are the foundation of physiological understanding of emotion. Neuroscience pioneers. A new studied field of science emerging during the 80s, it joined neurology, psychology, physiology, and medicine. Scientists like Daniel Goleman, Helen Riess, Tanya Singer, Daniel Siegel step in the new to known field, however necessary to better understand the nature of the mind, its motion and physiology. Daniel Goleman. His approach helped to realize that individuals are not made out from a single intelligence, but from a group of skills which allow to understand themselves and their social environment from an emotional point of view, and therefore made them more assertive. Helen Riess. Her studies are based on the ability of self-understanding as well as understanding of other emotions, and how these provide us with the ability to understand ourselves and our environment in an efficient manner. This ability is called empathy, and it develops over time. Tanya Singer. Her research is focused on how the development of the abilities as compassion and reflection can lead us to a state of well-being. It shows that the brain is an entity that has the capacity to change from these abilities. Daniel Siegel. His studies are based on the fact that our mind has the ability of self-understanding and that its development can lead to a better state for understanding ourselves, our environment, and the different aspects of our lives. Although the brief presentation of these authors, which perhaps leave out much of the words, many ideas can be drawn. Emotions have to be studied in a wide dimension. Our brain has malleability. It can eventually learn new skills regardless of age. Emotions can affect both patients and health staff. Proposal. The study of emotions, their centrum in the clear brain structure, provides us with a fertile scope for education in the areas of health. Scientific and technical approach should not move us away of realizing human needs and understanding an emotional intelligence. They should play a branding role for better understanding of all us. Emotional skill teaching should not be restricted only for specialties. Health career students should have contact with this knowledge, empathy, mindfulness, mindset, focus, compassion. To teach individuals this skill would allow not only to have personal qualified in emotion handling, but also to have persons who understand their environment and are prepared to deal with future life difficulties. Final message. Today, neuroscience represents an example of integration and emotional intelligence development in the health sector can give us an opportunity. Be willing to ask, but mostly be willing to see new possibilities on open roads.